Hi, this is Sadashu. In this video, I have come up with a new topic in artificial intelligence. Hope you have enjoyed the last video, and also I got good comments. Thank you for appreciating me, and I really need your support to reach more people. So in this presentation, I would like to define artificial intelligence in a different aspect. In last video lecture, I have defined artificial intelligence, but single definition don't cover all the aspects of artificial intelligence. So in this presentation, I am going to explain artificial intelligence in four different aspects. So first one is acting humanly, second one is thinking humanly, third one thinking rationally, and last one acting rationally. So now we will define AI in terms of four aspects one by one. So first we will take acting humanly. So we know that artificial intelligence is making intelligence machines, but with respect to above aspect, the artificial intelligence is whatever intelligent machines we are going to implement that should act like human. If machine wants to act like human, then following quality should be there in intelligent machine. So those qualities are, first one is a natural language process, second one is knowledge base, another one is automated reasoning, and next one is machine learning, and next one computer vision, and last one is robotics. So these qualities should be there if machine wants to act like human. So we will see what is natural language processing. So why natural language processing should be there in machine? So because that should communicate with outside world in whatever language specified. It may be English, Hindi, Marathi, or Kannada. So next one we will go to the knowledge base. Knowledge representation in artificial intelligence is to store what it knows or hear. Basically, it is a study of how the belief, intention, and judgment of any intelligent machine can express suitably for a particular task. Suppose, for example, if I tell a machine to cry, it should cry, but it won't laugh. So that is the best example for knowledge base. So next, we will go to the automated reasoning. So in automated reasoning, artificial intelligence to use the stored information to answer questions and draw new conclusion. For example, if I ask a question to the intelligent machine, what is the answer for 1 plus 1? The answer should be 2. So it won't give answer as a 3. So this is automated reasoning in intelligent machines. So next we'll go to the machine learning. So machine learning in artificial intelligence is to adapt to a new circumstance. For example, if you build a machine to maintain temperature of a particular industry, it should predict the environment temperature and maintain the temperature of the industry accordingly. So this is one of the good quality of acting humanly. So next one is computer vision. Computer vision is perceiving objects. This is related to image processing. If machine wants to act like human, then it should have a computer vision. For example, if I show an apple to the machine to recognize which fruit it is, so the answer should be apple, but it won't give the answer it as a orange. So this is the quality of computer vision in intelligent machine. So next one is robotics. Robotics in artificial intelligence is used to manipulate and move about. For example, if you build a machine to help blind people, then machine should have a proper functioning what blind person doesn't have. So these are the qualities of intelligent machines if it is wants to act like humanly. So the best method that is used to check whether the machine acting humanly or not, it is by using a Turing test proposed by Alan Turing in 1950. So this test is proposed to check whether the machine acts like human or not. Alan made three compartments. In one compartment, he placed the machine, and in second compartment, he assigned a person there, and in third compartment there is a person called evaluator, The evaluator is going to ask a question to machine and human, and ultimately he is going to get a response from both machine and human. But the evaluator is not able to predict whether the answer came from machine or human. Means machine giving answer like a human, therefore evaluator get confused. So if machine fools evaluator, then above machine we call it as intelligent machine. So Alan Turing test is the best example for thinking humanly. So next aspect of artificial intelligence is thinking humanly by using the cognitive model approach we are going to explain. So in artificial intelligence, one more aspect is intelligent machine should think like human. If you are going to say that a given machine think like a human, we must know how human think. So we need to get inside the actual working of human mind. There are two ways to do this. So first one is introspection. So what is meant by introspection? It is the examination or observation of one's own mental and emotional process. So another way to understand human mind is a psychological experiment. So what is meant by psychological experiment? A scientific procedure undertaken to make a discovery, test hypothesis, or demonstrate a known fact. From the above two ways, we can understand how human mind works. So once we have a sufficient precise theory of the mind, it become possible to express the theory as a computer program. So if the program input output and timing behavior matches with the corresponding human behavior, then we can call it as cognitive modeling. So in brief, I can tell you that cognitive model approach need how human mind works for a particular problem and how computer programs are right for the same problem. If these two aspects synchronized, then we can construct precise model. So this much explanation is enough to understand the concept of thinking humanly, but still I am thinking that I have to explain more about this thinking humanly concept. So I will show you a video of pigeon solve the classic box and banana problem. So why I have showing this video is that we should concentrate how pigeon solve the problem with good reasoning steps to eat the banana. So see, initially it is measuring how much height banana it is tied. Okay, so see the video, so you can get the concept. So it is measuring the height, then it will search for the possibility of resource to solve the problem, and it got the rectangular box. So now you see that it will move the rectangular box underneath of the banana. So see here, now it is moving the rectangular box. And finally, it will eat the banana. But here, we are not interested in how pigeon eat banana. We are really interested in how pigeon used reasoning steps to eat the banana. So such concepts contributed more in implementing artificial intelligence. So you can ask me question, what is the connection between this example and thinking humanly? See, already I have explained that if you want to implement cognitive modeling approach, we should understand how human mind works for a particular problem and how we can implement machine that can solve the same problem as human used steps to solve the problem. So in the case of pigeon also, we can write a computer program to solve the problem as same as that of how pigeon solve the problem to eat banana. So this is all about thinking humanly and cognitive model approach. So now we will go to third aspects of artificial intelligence, that is thinking rationally. that is the laws of thought approach. In artificial intelligence, thinking rationally means thinking rightly. For example, if something is true, that should be true, or that must be true, or it cannot false. If someone thinking rightly always in a given circumstance, in a given amount of information, then we can call it as a laws of thought approach. The Greek philosopher Aristotle was one of the first to attempt to codify right thinking for a structured argument. He always yielded a correct conclusion when given correct premises. For example, Socrates is a man, all men are mortal, therefore Socrates is mortal. So next one is, all men have brains, all human have brains, therefore all human are men. So such a thinking should be there in rational thinking. So this examples governs the right thinking. Actually, if you want to implement artificial intelligence with respect to thinking rationally, the laws of thought approach, there are two main obstacles exist. So first one is, this approach need 100% knowledge. If machine wants to think rightly, it has needed knowledge in all the domain. It's very difficult to have 100% knowledge. So, and also too many computations are required. If you want to implement AI in terms of right thinking, then so many computations are required, and also comparisons. So if any system has more computations, then economy of making such systems also increases. So in brief, I can tell you that if you want to implement machine in terms of thinking rationally, then machine should think 100% correctly. And also it is impossible to implement. So this is all about thinking rationally. So now I will explain a last approach, that is acting rationally, and also called rational agent. So first I will define what is an agent. So in general, we can define agent is a person who act on a behalf of another person. Suppose if you want to get a house in metro city, we will go through agent, and we know how agent is going to work. He is going to ask homeowner about rent, and he will get back to you and also help you to get home. And ultimately, he will get some money in between you and house owner. So in artificial intelligence, also same theory is going to apply. So in terms of artificial intelligence, agent is any that perceive its environment through sensors and acts upon that environment through effector or actuator. For example, if I build a rational agent for maintaining temperature of a particular room, it should have a temperature sensor to detect temperature. And if room temperature is more than the specified temperature, then agent has to take action through effector or actuator to reduce the temperature. So such agents are really needed in AI. So we can see different types of agent. So first one is a human agent. So human itself, a human agent has sensory organs such as eyes, ear, nose, tongue and skin parallel to the sensor, and other organs such as hands, legs, mouth for a effector. And another agent we can call a robotic agent. So the sensory organ for the robotic is like camera and infrared range finders, and it has a various motors and actuators for its effector. And also one more agent is there, that is software agent, has a keystroke, file content, received network packages which acts as a sensor, and display on the screen file, sent network packets acts an actuator. So this is all about concept of acting humanly, thinking rationally and acting rationally. So thank you for listening the presentation. For more videos related to artificial intelligence, please subscribe the channel. Thank you.